We begin with some developing news from the Commonwealth Games. Five athletes from Cameroon have gone missing from the athletes' village in Gold Coast, Australia. Cameroon team manager Victor Agbor Nso has reportedly said that weightlifter Olivier Matam and boxers Ndzie, Tchoyi and Simplice, Fotsala had been due to compete this week but could not be found. Another two other weightlifters, Aka Angeline, Filji and Mikoumba, Petit, had disappeared earlier. Gold Coast authorities say there are mechanisms in place to deal with the situation if the athletes overstay their visas.
In terms of the athletes, I just simply say enjoy Australia while you're here. This includes Cameroon or any other athletes. Stay within the law and be mindful of the fact that there is a system in place in this country, and we would appreciate them sticking within the law, enjoying themselves, but sticking within the law. And if they are thinking of doing anything other, then I would encourage them not to do it.
Joining us on the line from Sydney for more on this is CGTN's Greg Navarro. Greg, what is the latest on these five Cameroonian athletes? Have they been located yet?
I'm sorry, could you repeat your question? I'm having a hard time hearing you.
Have these five Cameroonian athletes been located?
At this point, they have no idea where those athletes are. It, as you heard, if all the Australian federal police, they're perfectly legal within the bounds of their temporary activity visas, which expire at the beginning of next month. This is not the first time that athletes have come here from other countries for an event such as the Commonwealth Games and then suddenly disappeared, at least from the village. In 2006, the Commonwealth Games were held in Melbourne, and a total of more than 40 athletes and team officials, more than 20 from many from Sierra Leone, actually went missing during the competition, didn't show up for their events or went missing from the village. Many of the Sierra Leone athletes eventually turned themselves into immigration officials, but they either tried to overstay their visas in those cases or apply for asylum.
Greg, the local organizing committee issued a stern warning to these athletes. What are the repercussions for those found culpable?
Well, many countries actually warned their athletes, were told, before coming here to Australia about behaving, honoring the visas that you've received, and in essence giving them warnings not to attempt to seek asylum, to use the event as an opportunity to do so. As far as the repercussions go, as you've heard, that again, they haven't broken any laws in this country. They've simply gone missing from the games, which, of course, I suppose there certainly will be repercussions, from team officials and state officials. But as far as they're concerned here in Australia, they've broken no laws. They're simply still within the bounds of those visas.
Greg Navarro in Sydney, thank you very much for joining us.